Hey kids, today we're making a loaded potato casserole.
Yay!
It's cooking and crafting, yeah, cooking and crafting. It's YouTube's best for creative things, it's cooking and crafting.
I went ahead and I pre-cooked my russet potatoes. You use between 3.5 to 4 pounds, and you peel them and cut them into quarters and go ahead and cook them nicely. You could leave this in the pan that you cooked it in, but just so that I have more space with, you know, the ingredients and such around me, I just put it into the bowl. But it's just to go ahead and cover it with salted water and bring it to a boil and cook it until tender, then drain well. I've already preheated my oven to 350, so you've missed the boops. We're going to mash these potatoes until they're almost smooth. I kind of like the idea of a chunky, so I might not do it until they are smooth, and I'll just, you know, kind of rebel against that. Now we're going to add in 1/2 cup of cream cheese. I did leave mine out on the counter for just a little bit, not very long. You don't have to, but since it's going to go into the oven, but we're going to add in 1/2 cup of that. I'm guessing that's about 1/2 cup right there. And we're gonna add in some sour cream, butter, milk, salt, and pepper. Hang on a sec. We have here 1/4 cup of milk, 1/4 cup of butter, and then you can add in, okay, the butter. There you go. It was just a tad resistant. A teaspoon of salt, and freshly ground pepper, about 1/2 teaspoon. And then what we're going to do is we're going to continue mashing this. It says until smooth. There we go. And I'm going to just go until I see my butter and such begin to get a little more melted. Let me continue doing this. I'll be right back, all right? I'm not sure where that cut off. I stirred in 1 1/2 cups of cheddar in there, and it calls for 8 strips of bacon. But I decided on a spur of the moment to make this. So at this point, we're adding bacon pieces. And so you put in either your bacon or your bacon pieces and figure out about how much you think 8 pieces would be worth. If you're a bacon lover like me, you just kind of toss it in there all willy-nilly like, okay? So here we go with our little casserole. Let me cover my bacon, my pepper. Spray your casserole dish and go ahead and put this into your dish. It asks to make an irregular top, you know, like don't make it look so refined, make it look all rustic and whatnot. And so that helicopter or plane going overhead, that's a helicopter. Yeah, we'll make it look like that. And we're going to put this into the oven for 20 minutes. We're not gonna cover it, we're just gonna put it in as is. So we'll be back in 20 minutes, all right? And we're back. So we're gonna put on that last 1/2 cup of cheese, but the other 1/2 of the bacon is to be added in now. So I'll just add just something to make it look pretty. And this probably should have been a longer, flatter pan, but I always think ahead, you know, like refrigerator space, and it's just easier for me to find space for something this small versus a 9x13 pan. And then half of a bunch of green onions, which is actually quite a lot. So we'll just put in a little bit of this. And then we're going to return this to the oven for about 5 minutes just to melt the cheese. Fairly quick, hey? Loaded potato casserole. Enjoy. This is just incredible. Love this flavor. Love, love, love it. I hope you give me a thumbs up. I'll see you in the next video.
Thank you for watching.